Hi everyone, hope all are well. In this online module, we are going to start a new chapter of class 11, Snapshot, that is Mother's Day. It is a play written by J.B. Priestley. Dear students, it is a very humorous and satirical play based on the condition of a woman in her family. And Mother's Day is a very beautiful chapter that depicts the status of a woman, particularly a housewife in a family. So your mother or any of the Indian mother, basically she can relate herself with this mother. And also, moreover, a housewife dedicates all her time and precious time and services to her family, but at last what she gets? Basically, this is a play where we will find that the mother, who is giving so much to her family, ultimately was neglected or kind of taken for granted attitude by the family members, and then she got frustrated and dejected and disillusioned by this kind of condition. And then one of her friends, a very sweet friend of hers, she helped her, and we will see that how she helps. That is a very interesting point here. So there are different characters in the play that play a major role. Basically, Mrs. Annie Pearson is there, George Pearson is there, Doris Pearson, Cyril Pearson, they belong to one family, and of course the main character Annie Pearson, and then her friend Mrs. Fitzgerald. So the particular scene that the play has opened in a living room, when the curtain rises, it is an afternoon in early autumn, and the stage can be well lit. Mrs. Pearson at right and Mrs. Fitzgerald at left, all both were sitting and discussing about their lives. Mrs. Fitzgerald has been telling Mrs. Pearson's fortune, so she was a fortune teller. Mrs. Pearson is a pleasant but worried looking woman, so underline this. And she was pleasant and worried looking woman. She was 40s, in her 40s, and Mrs. Fitzgerald is older, heavier, stronger and sinister personality. She's smoking. It is very important that these two should have sharply contrasting voices. So both are contrasting with each other, contradictory with each other. So there is a sharp contrast in their persona. Mrs. Pearson speaking in a light, a flurried sort of tone with a touch of suburban Cockney perhaps, and Mrs. Fitzgerald with a deep voice, rather Irish perhaps. So this was a short introduction about the character, which is given in your book in the beginning itself. And this particular play, as it is very lengthy and it takes almost two lessons, so we are going to, I have decided to just shortly divide this play in two parts. So today I'm going to read and then I will explain little bit about it. So let's begin with the introduction. So the play is very interestingly defining the two characters, the condition of a mother, Annie Pearson. She was a wife and had a ruined family. Ruined family means all were doing and working on their own will. No one is listening to anyone, and it's a complete mess in her family. She had daughter, son and a husband. She saw all her children and husband consider her as a slave or a servant. So the condition was very miserable in the family. She longed for a change but was not prepared to make this change. In her opinion, everyone would feel upset if she corrected them. So this was a really very bad condition of Annie Pearson. And one fine day, Annie was paid a visit by her neighbor, Mrs. Fitzgerald. So that very day was a very turning point in her life when Fitzgerald visited her. One thing you should know about Mrs. Fitzgerald, as we know that she was a very strong character, a symbol of feminism. She you know, places our voice in a very strong and stubborn manner. Having found Annie in such a mess, Mrs. Fitzgerald felt sorry for her, so she decided to help her and help her coming out from this miserable condition. So she decided to exchange the personalities, exchange the character, and this was very important clue given in the chapter that both have decided to exchange their personality. You will ask me how can it be possible. So she is a fortune teller and she knows little bit of necromancy or a magic or a black magic, you can say. So she had a good hand in it and she tried exchanging. She uttered some magical spells and then she exchanged the personality. That's a very humorous part here. Having found Annie in such a mess, she did that, and once this done, the real Annie goes out and Fitzgerald remains in home as Annie and wait, and you know, then she started reacting and responding to different family members. At first, Doris returns from his office. Doris is Mrs. Pearson's daughter. So she must be around 20 or more. When Doris entered, she found her mother smoking cigarette and drinking bouts. So that was really a surprise for Doris. She actually looked up her mother that what happened this very day. She was smoking and how suddenly she can change. What kind of drastic change in the personality. So entire thing was changed and she was in shock, startled. Having changed personality, Fitzgerald declared that she had decided not to cook for them, iron their clothes and wait for them to have food. She made it very clear that she was not willing to work in the house unless she were paid due to respect and be thanked for every favor. So here you will see the change which Miss Fitzgerald is bringing in Annie's life, any person's life, Pearson's life, and how she is making these changes by a very stubborn outlook. She just rejected to work, cook, and even iron their clothes, because before, when Annie Pearson was doing all this, it's becoming so much monotonous and routine that no one is actually considering her as a human or a family member. Everyone was taking it for granted and no one is giving her respect to. So first step towards getting her identity back, Mrs. Fitzgerald decided not to work. And then finally came the head of the family, George Pearson. When he saw what her children had seen and heard more than that the children had heard, George found no tongue in his mouth. His wife had never been like this. She called him a name that his friends teased him at the club. Pompey Pearson. This is a very nice expression given in your text. When we will read, we will just point out once again. And also, she behaved in the same manner with her son. So, having changed personality, she was behaving like this. Her wife had never been like that. He was shocked totally. The family learnt a great lesson at the end that Mrs. Fitzgerald taught them. Later, the two friends returned to their own characters and play ended happily. So this was a short gist about the play Mother's Day, written by J.B. Priestley. So first, please write about Annie Pearson character sketch. One by one, I'm giving you the short introduction about the characters now before starting the reading part. So Annie Pearson, a humble woman, the mother of two teenage children. She is the sufferer. She is the victim of being, neglected by the family. Because she is not fond of correcting her husband and children, Annie is expected to be a silent figure in the family, doing all their work silently. And she was not at all, strong. She was worried looking. She was weak, miserable, and listening to all the commands very silently, so kind of submissive character. Then we have George Pearson, Annie's husband. Self-importance, he had a self-importance. He is not respected in the society too. There are instances because his friends do bully him by keeping his names. He is gentle with his children, especially with daughter Doris, who is a ruined girl. So Doris Pearson. Doris is again a girl who is very bad in her code of conduct. She is having very miserable mannerisms here. She is already into an affair with a young man of the name Charlie Spence. She expects her mother to do all her work and she never understands her mother's misery. So Cyril Pearson is a boy. He is the son of Annie, and he also takes her mother for granted. Then Mrs. Fitzgerald, the neighbor, she had spent her years in eastern countries where her husband had been a lieutenant quartermaster. She had learnt a little magic and black magic also, and because of that, both of them, Mrs. Fitzgerald and Mrs. Annie Pearson, they exchanged their personalities, and she helped Mrs. Pearson in coming out of that troubled state where she was. Then magic is again an important role in this particular play. It is actually done by Mrs. Fitzgerald, and she did it very successfully. She did it very confidently. No one suspected on her persona too. And then the first scene, the play opened in the living room where Mrs. Pearson was sitting with near the fireplace. With Mrs. Fitzgerald, as I had told you. And there's a picture in your text. You can see that how both of them are chit-chatting over the cup of coffee and other taking the drink and cigarette. So the story begins with both Mrs. Pearson and Mrs. Fitzgerald sitting opposite to each other. And Mrs. Fitzgerald is a fortune teller. She had suppressed seen Mrs. Pearson's fortune. Thus, she continues to say that she has told her all that in within her capacity to tell. The same reading can work in a positive way if Mrs. Pearson's actions are in sync with it, or it could turn out to be bad too. Mrs. Pearson expresses her gratitude towards Mrs. Fitzgerald for having seen her fortune and shares how great it is to know about it. Now Mrs. Fitzgerald answers that she did learn that art from East, and while her father was climbing the ladder to become lieutenant quartermaster, she was learning this. She then motivates Mrs. Pearson to stand for herself and get the respect. So she motivates Mrs. Pearson to get the respect. Now Mrs. Fitzgerald wants Mrs. Pearson to realize that it is not that difficult, that she realizes she has to try for her dignity, she has to try for her identity which has been lost in the family. And this is how they both decided to exchange their personality. Mrs. Fitzgerald is trying to make her understand that it's high time now, she has to take some major decision, and she gave a kind of confidence. Mrs. Pearson agrees to Mrs. Fitzgerald, and both of them decided finally, they did the arrangement, and Mrs. Fitzgerald stops her for doing so. She wants to clear it out with her family and take her stand, but she didn't. She just don't know how to take the first step. So this is how the friend actually gave her the confidence to take the first step ahead for the new beginning, or to change the approach of the family members. Then Mrs. Pearson tells her that she doesn't think it's a good idea. She was a little hesitant. She was a little fearful about the change. But Mrs. Fitzgerald was very firm this time. She affirms that she meant the same, but she will not be taking her place as herself. She will become Mrs. Pearson when the things will be okay. So this is how the whole sequence on page number 32, 33 and 34 is there, which gives you an idea about it. In a very relaxed tone, Mrs. Fitzgerald tells her that she had tried it before, and even though it's been long, the trick should work. Its effect will remain for a short period, but enough for them to fulfill their motives. See, Mrs. Fitzgerald wants to change the family members. So she further added, while holding Mrs. Pearson's hand, she had acquired the trick from the East. So this is how both of them have exchanged it, and the personalities have now been switched into one another. The transmission process is complete. With snatching away the cigarette from Mrs. Fitzgerald's hand, she is confident about the success of her trick. Now Mrs. Fitzgerald looks at herself, and she is shocked to see herself in the body of Mrs. Fitzgerald. I mean Mrs. Fitzgerald, who is now Mrs. Pearson, and Mrs. Pearson, who is now Mrs. Fitzgerald. Mrs. Fitzgerald in the body of Mrs. Pearson is quite comfortable, but Mrs. Pearson in the body of Mrs. Fitzgerald is not comfortable. She was shocked. So this is how the play starts up. Now, grim word is used here, that means bitterly or hard manner. She was harshly tells worried Mrs. Pearson that her family will face Mrs. Fitzgerald, who is now in her body. The secret is only theirs and the family will not know anything about it. In an attempt to comfort her, she tells the real Mrs. Pearson that she would anyway have more privilege and fun being Mrs. Fitzgerald while living her life. So we will see in my next video, you will see that how in the exchange personality Mrs. Fitzgerald acts like Mrs. Pearson and changes the attitude slowly or gradually.